I'm gonna let Celia in. She just sent me a text.
Oh.
Are your kids enjoying the programs?
Yeah, we were away a lot last week.
Uh-huh.
But we were back for a trip on Friday. I went with them to Wentworth State Park.
Oh, yeah, how was that?
Yeah, it was great. We were the only ones there. Because it was the day that before here, but up there, and the ice cream was not raining. It wasn't, it was a little overcast, but it was a lot, but kids are still swimming.
Yeah, I'm not sure we can do much. Well, we can, I mean, we can't make any decisions.
Oh, Celia, I love the hair.
I know, she's gonna say, where'd it all go?
Good, did you have it done recently?
Wednesday.
Wow, did you donate it?
No, I just had it chopped off.
It's gorgeous.
It looks really nice.
I love it.
So I'll let you catch up with everyone, start here. Start now, so we just, we're just talking over. So we can't make any decisions, right?
No, it's a workshop instead of a meeting.
So now we have to go out of.
Adjourn the meeting and call a workshop until more people get here.
If they come.
If they come.
So, okay, adjourn the meeting at 7:06. Yeah. What else do I do? Do we do any on?
Second, wait a second. Somebody, second?
Yeah. And then open workshop. At 7:07 PM. Do we know if the directors or anybody?
Nope. They are, yeah.
They're not coming. So, in spirit of getting through this quickly, we can,
Hey, Blythe.
Hi.
So we need one more.
One more, yep. I'm not sure if Jody's even gonna make it because of,
Jody's coming, she's in already, just got phone with her.
Okay, so we're in workshop right now. We can't, make any decisions, but we can have conversations.
Okay.
And we can go back into meeting when, if and when Jody gets here.
Okay.
So I was just telling them in the spirit of getting through this quickly.
Yep.
So approval of meeting, let's just, meeting minutes, let's just table over them.
Okay.
Okay. So I wanted to talk about what I call the Camp Raleigh retrospective. So it's just a review of the first 2 weeks of summer camp. Things we can start doing, stop doing, or continue doing. It's hard, I was telling Kathy, it's hard to give a full-blown look at it because your director and assistant director aren't here. I can only give you what I've been told and had conversations with them about, things that could change or whatever. So I'll start with scheduling. So as the week and a half went on, we took a look at the schedule as a whole and realized that we may have been a little bit too, I shouldn't say aggressive, so aggressive is not really the word I'm looking for, maybe a little bit too structured and scheduled. The feedback I've received from parents and I received from Brittany is maybe loosening it up a little bit more free time. It's really great to have the structured time and I'm not moving away from that. But we're thinking about, or I'm gonna present back to Andy and Brittany, maybe going more towards a stationed schedule as opposed to an age group schedule. Some of the parents have told me that they like to, they'd like some of the kids to intermingle a little bit more. I can agree to a point, depending on the skill levels when it comes to organized sports. I think that they should still stay within the groups, but when it comes to free time or adding a little bit more free time in the arts and crafts, there's no reason why we have to keep them in the groups. And I think even for lunches, there's no reason why they have to stay in the groups.
I don't know if they do over lunch.
I've heard different things, so I'm not really sure where it actually lands.
I've been on both of the state park trips, and things on the state park trips are fairly loose, you know, in the sense that, you know, kids are playing with everybody. You know, if you want to play football, you can play football, you know, swings, you go and play the swings, but there's been a really good eyes on everybody, and it's been really good both times.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, with the one we just did Friday, it went where there was only 36 kids there in the full counselor load, and I was there, so you know, it was kind of pretty easy. But
yeah.
The Tuckaway one, I think it was like 50 or so kids. And but anyway, so I think on those days, it definitely, I see that there's a lot of intermingling between age groups and whatnot. We had a football game or a kickball game going, and we had some, like, you know, some of those second, third grade kids playing with counselors and some of the older kids, and everybody mixed together. So you're seeing, I saw that going on there. I haven't been around during like the regular days, so I don't know about that.
Yeah, Andy mentioned to me that he thought it was, maybe there were certain times during the day they didn't necessarily need to be in age groups. So it's almost like, okay, so guys, 30 minutes, just for example. Okay, 30 minutes, my age group is doing sandcastles. No, okay, guys, you're going to stop with sandcastles. It's pump the water. It's sort of like that. I mean, it's structured, but maybe too structured for the age groups. It's always a money can to make a lot of certain situations. So he's taking a look at that. I think it's going to be a little bit looser. There should be no safety issues, because it should still be a stationed environment as opposed to a, you know, watch your age group. You're basically watching the group that's there in front of you. So he's going to take a look at that. I suggest it to him tomorrow. And it has not been negative feedback. It was just more of a constructive
tweaking.
Yeah, constructive tweak, which, you know, again, it's not safety related or anything.
I know when I saw them at the library later that day, the first week, he said it was tight between picking up pizza and then getting the kids, that maybe the flow just needed to be adjusted, that it's, and he wasn't sure if the library was expecting us for a certain amount of time, or us to be there at a specific time and to leave at a specific time. So
I think if it's Sarah, she emailed me and said, you know, the kids came down, they were great, you know, they come often. Yeah, so she's very flexible when it comes to that. I mean, very slow in summer. So
I think Andy was asking, and Brittany actually too, asking if we could flip flop Wednesdays and Mondays, so that Mondays they go to the public library as opposed to Wednesdays. Is that something that you could check on for us? Maybe see if there's an issue
there,
Mondays?
I couldn't imagine. Maybe it's not open. Library isn't open Friday.
No,
Friday, Saturday.
But they're open Monday.
Yeah.
And are you concerned about other things being scheduled during the day?
Yeah, I mean, there's the
we just
little
don't
kids'
want
story
to
hour.
Out.
That kind of
so
thing.
The story hour actually for the summer has been moved to Wednesday evening.
Oh, okay.
So the space is clear during the day for the groups to come and visit whenever that works for them.
Monday seems pretty open.
Yeah, Monday would be a good day.
Yeah.
Erica.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hey, Jody. Is 2,000 music here yet?
He what?
His tooth doesn't need to work out yet.
It's close. I'm in a workshop right now, so with you here, we can actually move into
awesome
meeting. So, how do I do that? Motion to end workshop and enter into?
Motion to close workshop.
Motion to close
and non-public.
And open into non-public. 7:14. Give me a second on that.
Second.
I
second.
No, okay. That's okay. I'll talk. You breathe. we're talking about scheduling. So the first thing we're hitting on our agenda is scheduling. And I was just telling them some of the feedback I got from Amy and Brittany is maybe the scheduling was going really great. They're just thinking about a little bit more free time with more of a station sort of environment as opposed to age group.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping age groups still when you got the organized sports and things that make sense to separate them.
Right.
But when it comes to more free time, which they want to actually work into the schedule, more of a stationed thing. So
right.
You don't have to pick up and move your age group. You know, you're stationed. So you've got so-and-so on the playground. You've got so-and-so doing organized sports with the kids and sort of like that. So I think, and I've had a few constructive feedback items from parents about that. I don't disagree, actually. I think it's a good thing.
Yeah, like, exactly. So we're at a play in the playground and bands.
Yeah.
And Brittany is wanting to do dance, so And Zoe wants a new name, so.
Yeah, I'm gonna talk to, when I check in the kids tomorrow, I'll talk to the person. But anyways, I'll talk to him about that, moving it in that direction. So that's really all, kind of what we've got. Oh, we're talking about moving the library from Wednesday to Mondays. Just because, and this sort of like a longer time period there that Andy wanted to use.
Oh, yeah.
To get the kids in a rotational, you know. So anyways, we're gonna move Andy, move the kids to.
That poses a problem for.
For what?
The Wentworth House has agreed to take the kids on a Monday, two Mondays. But we need to let them know the time and whether or not we're still interested. I had told them Monday afternoons and they got back to me and said, Mondays or Thursdays, and they said July 24th, July 27th, and August 7th, but they need three people for volunteers up there. Right now they have two for Mondays and they're meeting tomorrow night. So they said preferably Mondays and then they only have to get one volunteer for them. But they could cycle through too. We did it three Mondays or 3 days so that not all the kids have to go the same day. So whatever kids go to the Wentworth House can go and the other kids can go to the library.
Oh.
Or the other Tiffany.
So it's almost like offering two.
But they would like to know if we're still interested so they can talk to their board. And
can I let you know in the morning?
Okay. And I also said that some of us on the committee, including myself, may be able to swing to help be there on Monday afternoon if we were there.
Yeah,
okay.
I can help. I'll bring a little guy that I bring with.
And so I also need to contact the directors and find out if they can email me the list of the parents who signed their kids up to go.
Yeah, because I don't know if they're comfortable with that.
What is the feedback from your kids? Like, are they thinking they're too busy, or are they bored, or what is the feedback from?
They need shade. Mine need shade and water time. So there's no water time. And there's not enough shade.
Okay.
So, easy ups and come through, like I told me. So, and once that park gets really, like, really not a lot of shade, they know. So,
yeah. More shade, more water?
Yeah. No, just shade. They,
and so
there's no water time, like squirt guns and stuff like that. Sprinkle time. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So
they're
sitting in the hot sun. Well, that happened too, but that's a whole other story. So.
What's up?
No, just like they just needed to be reminded. The little ones needed to be reminded of put your lunch back in your lunchbox and zip it up because, you know, things were coming home with like the half eaten apple in the bag. The bears are like, what happened?
Yeah.
So we got code hooks for the fence, if you noticed. All the bags are lining up along the fence.
I did,
now.
And they're fantastic.
So I went to go buy bins, but I couldn't find bins big enough for a cheap enough price. So the dollar store bins just didn't hold those giant backpacks. Some of the kids have really big backpacks. So we put all the backpacks go along the fence, and, you know, the water bottles and stuff. So at least they're lined up, they're off the ground, the ants aren't at it, because they eat, the little ones eat way in the back. And I was having more ants in the backpack than I was at my own house. So,
that's a good idea.
Yeah, so we got the SFX and all the backpacks now on the hooks. So, solve that problem. But my kids are missing water time. So,
okay.
So.
I wonder if they know about the tool, you know, to open up the spigot outside. Because when I just realized this on Thursday when I was there that they were filling up the watering cans in the teacher's room sink. When outside, right there where the little water fountain is outside, if you, I use a wrench to open it and it does, the water comes out like a spigot. So they could make more water toys and use that for water toys rather than using the teacher room sink.
Some sort of a sprinkler in the shed, I know.
Did anybody?
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, so there's a whole, there's some.
There's a long hose too, yeah.
And what other camps have.
The stuff's there.
Yeah, and what other camps have done is just get a couple of kitty homes filled with water, kids take their squirt guns.
Yeah.
Cause there's a ton of squirt guns ready to go.
Yeah.
Those are in the shed too.
Okay.
So they just need.
Squirt guns in the shed.
You just need a wrench to open the spigot.
Do we know if the hose works? Or if it's got any problem? I don't know, maybe I can get somebody to check out tomorrow.
I can go there tomorrow and check out that hose and go with a wrench.
Okay, awesome.
So then I'll just leave a wrench there if they can use it.
Okay, alright, that's great. So I'm hoping no more. So more water play, more shade. So James brought that up to me too, about the shade. He says, well, they don't let us in as much as they probably could.
Yeah, I asked him if they play in the gym, and he's always said no.
And everybody's
at
the same time.
Yeah, and they're not allowed up on the stage unless the counselor's up there.
Why?
I don't know. So
I did stop by the first week, and the maintenance man from the school said they had the camp staff had forgotten to unplug one of the games, like the air hockey game, had been plugged in all night. And he brought it up to the directors, so I'm hoping that was taken care of, and maybe that is part of the reason they're not allowed on the stage. So.
Okay.
Okay, what else? So as far as scheduling, I just had a couple of questions for you. So Thursday, ice cream. Are we still on? I'm pointing for ice cream?
Yes. Brittany, I emailed Brittany and sent Michelle the number of people that signed up so she can go buy shopping.
Okay. Saw that she on her news. Did you see Brittany's newsletter?
Yeah.
No.
I should have gone home with you
Brittany
kids.
Brittany that put that together?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they sent it to me to print. She makes it.
Yeah, I only got it by print because it was in the stack.
Yep, you should be getting it by print. Absolutely. And I was going to do a survey to all the parents about the field trips, but they ended up putting it in the newsletter instead, asking if the headcounts, more about headcounts for buses.
Oh.
So they're going to be more diligent about asking parents as they come in, oh, so field trip's coming up Wednesday, will so-and-so be going? So they have a better handle on that as far as buses are concerned.
I'm trying to. Andy said that there were 57 kids at that first Pawtuckaway trip. So why do we have so much trouble with that bus that held 84? That's what I can get.
I think, wasn't there more kids than that?
I would know about.
Maybe there was 75? Okay, so maybe he just misspoke when I was talking to him.
I think there were, I think the
I thought so too.
A little bit higher than that.
Because
I didn't realize how big the 1-3 group was. And I thought it was 19 and it's 39 or something like that.
I did head count sheets for a couple things, and there are exactly 75 kids signed up for camp.
Yeah.
Well, there were 78,
75. Oh, I took over a list of 75 of ones I had, and I said, please check this, because I heard you had 78. And he says, we recounted, and there's 75.
75.
So it's not 76, 78, there's 75.
Ricky
that's
told,
what I was told.
Ricky told me that this past week it was about half that every day.
Yeah.
You know, which is understandable with 4th of July.
Yeah, I was going to say that would be
they said that there was 40 something kids that went on Friday. So it was at
turn
six, that's why I said
that. Yeah.
So I asked what the headcount was, and it was like 41 or something.
Yeah. I heard 36, but 30,
all
you know,
over the place.
36, 40.
But
they do. During the day at those field trips, they...
Well, at least they're signing in and out, so we can count them if we
want
to.
Yeah, so they're saving their attendance sheets for me.
Yes.
And Andy pulls the groups together every half hour, every hour, and they do head counts just like throughout the day, which is a good thing.
Yeah.
And they've been doing the box for the swimming. That's worked out really well.
Mm-hmm.
The kids are all just localized in that box, and they don't even think outside the box, and so that's worked out well.
My 11-year-old said that he liked the idea of on the field trips with the water, it's coming in every 30 minutes. And I didn't think that he would like that at all, because he's just that kid. But he was like, yeah, no, that's a great idea.
What, to just swim?
Every 30 minutes or so, he'll ask the counselors to take attendance, to make sure everybody's in.
Oh, that's
great. They have to come out of the water and do a head count before they can go back in.
Yeah.
Zach,
some
people
feel like
not like that.
Yeah. It depends, you know.
But he dealt with it.
But like, James is like all about structure.
Yeah.
And so, not that Zach isn't, but probably not as much.
Yeah.
I mean,
he didn't want to be disrupted in the same castle.
From what I was told.
All right, so the other scheduling item I needed to ask you about was the week of July 17th. It was learned about the Rollinsburg Explorers. Is that still going to happen, do you think?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Just one police department's coming. Wait a minute. Let me check my Yeah, we have the police department on a week before.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I don't think that Explorers.
Okay, that's fine. They can
yeah.
just open that up to
yeah.
free time.
Yeah. Yeah, and we have, and Taylor is going to check her schedule and see when she can come back.
Okay.
Oh, did she come in already?
Yeah, she
oh,
came
cool.
in this past Thursday.
Went really well.
And
did
your kids
like it?
Mine
wasn't
there.
Taylor? Yeah,
the singer songwriter?
They
didn't mention the word to me.
Yeah, it went really well.
They
didn't
love it.
They didn't die yet.
Well,
that
was actually not the second, it's probably not following her.
Oh, if it was in the afternoon.
You know, right off the bat, you know, she introduced herself and they were asking her questions like, what chord you can play a song in, and then, do you play the same chords for every song, or the questions were unbelievable. She handled them so well. And
it must have been fun for her too, yeah.
Yeah, she really enjoyed it. She had to shut off the questions because she didn't have enough time to answer them all. So the kids asked her to learn a whole bunch of songs, and so she said she would, and she tried to come back. And then the animal shelter, that went really well. I was so impressed with the kids. They really are fantastic. And the staff were fantastic, too, with the Kachiko. I don't know, did your kids like it?
Yeah,
I
loved
it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
I loved it.
Yeah, they asked for a dog.
Every day.
Well, you can tell them that dog got adopted.
Oh,
he did. He got adopted by the lady who came and demonstrated.
Oh,
so,
if you're talking about scheduling, a week from tomorrow is July 17th, which is Doodlebugs coming in the morning. On that Monday morning.
What time?
She's going to start at 10, and she's going to cycle through all the kids.
For how long?
It's going to be like a half an hour or so for each group.
Is it groups of 20?
Groups of 24. So, and she needs to be on the stage with tables set up.
Stage with tables.
Yes.
All right.
And then the other thing, next Thursday, Kelly was working on this, and I was wondering where we stood. She was looking at getting transportation for buses on July 20th, which is that Thursday, to go to the UNH animals, the Woodman Institute, in the morning, at 10 in the morning.
Is this something that came up last meeting?
Yes. And
they do lunch on the...
It's a free thing at the Woodman Institute.
All right, she sent me a note on this. Now I know what you guys are talking about. I contacted the guy about the Wednesday 20th trip to Woodman Museum on Ocean Day.
It's supposed to be Thursday, but yeah, that one.
We could go at 10 a.m. if we want. There's also a new playground down the street. Oh, she's talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, so 10 o'clock or 10 a.m. on the 20th?
Yes. And then that would get them back in time for the police department in the afternoon. They could eat lunch at the Woodman Institute. But they needed bus transportation.
That's Thursday?
Yeah.
You know what? Why don't we bump the police department? Because they're very flexible.
Okay.
I can ask them to go the following Thursday. Because.
That would be fun.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because then they can stay at the water park.
Yeah.
The water park. The playground sprinkler thingy.
just opened, and then you got water and
yeah. We were there the first day.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah.
And they have
it's cool. So cool. I love it. Blue Moon Music, Ocean Day. So it'll be 10 a.m. Jason's so we'll need to get a bus. Yeah, we're going to charge the kids $5 per bus.
Okay.
I don't know.
That was here prepaid for
all the
8 weeks to field trips.
Yeah, but I didn't use
them. I mean, excuse me.
No. Yeah.
That brings up another question. On your Ocean Day.
Yeah, that's fine. It's just, you know, we're going on an extra field trip. Plus money needed for whatever. So, we'll be getting splash pad and the minimal and
Ocean animals.
Thank you.
So. Yeah, it sounds wonderful then.
And then you'll move the police department?
Yeah.
Okay. So the following Thursday, which is July 27th, was the one Thursday that the Wentworth House said they could do. But that's depending
okay.
on kids, because that would be in the afternoon. But if we don't have, I was going to send 3 groups of 25 over there, but if we don't, there was concern that the older kids may not want to go at our last meeting. So if they didn't, if we only have enough for the 2 Mondays, then we'll just do the 2 Mondays and that. And I, as soon as we know, I'm going to send up.
I don't think we signed up for any of that yet.
There's the first week she said. Is
I thought I we signed something when I checked them in one morning.
I signed up for
check them out.
This week. I signed up.
If we, at our last meeting, we discussed if we went to the ocean animal things, we are not going to bring in any ocean, any animals, even though we had a donor give us $250 requesting an animal show.
Oh. Requesting an animal show.
Well,
that's right.
For activities. But we were going to go to the Woodman Institute on the 20th.
Can't you just use the $250 for the bus?
That's what the suggestion had been.
That way the kids don't have to pay.
Yeah,
no
idea.
I think that's a great idea.
Because they are seeing animals.
Do we know when baby is happening?
Supposed to start this week.
Oh, I haven't got
wait, hold on.
Wait, I think Kelly may have said something to her about too.
So it's on the 20th, perfect.
Because I had talked to Center for Wildlife and they were gonna come in August 3rd. If
July 18th starts work on Wiley Street. Parents will need alternate entry for drop off pickup.
But not the paving in the parking lot.
So attending the meeting on Wednesday regarding culverts, July 25th starts paving basketball court. Oh,
July 25th.
Yeah, starts paving for basketball for July 18th on the street.
So where will pick up and drop off be? Did we decide that?
That was going to be up to Brittany and Kate. Brittany's dealing directly with Kate, so there's not a lot of middleman people. So they were going to have an exit and entry point for us.
So we have 1 week
in the back.
They have 1 week to notify parents of where pickup and drop off will be.
And I think that's a 2 to 3 day process. So if it's the 18th, they're on the 25th.
On the 25th.
Field trip. Right? Tuesday's field trip day?
Tuesday.
So do we want to tentatively put field trips on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday that week?
Can you move the swim?
Action. 2 weeks to think about it. So, and that all depends on if it rains or not, then the next couple of weeks, whatever was doing the paving, the throw can push back too. So,
okay, so I'll see what can have Kelly ask about that. Okay.
So, just to clear things up, the donation that came in for an animal show was being used for the bus. to transport the kids to
UN, the UN.
To the Woodman Institute. Would that cover the bus? It's a $250 donation.
Well, the bus is $36 an hour, so it depends on how long you're there. And how many kids actually go. So, I don't know, let's just say what? It's like 6 hours, it's $216, right? Means we need 43 kids to go to break even for that bus.
It won't be on 6 hours, though. It starts at, I know, but what I'm saying is, it will be less than
if they leave at 9:30 and get there, or 9:45 to get there, and then come back like 2 o'clock.
So oh, okay.
The bus gets there.
So utilize the park.
Because it takes an hour to get up. It was a quite interesting show.
Gotcha. So maybe you're right on the 6 hour. Like 6 hours, probably going down the street.
Okay.
So like 9 to 3.
Okay.
That gives them an hour to get loaded and get over there,
mm-hmm.
and they can play like do the Woodman thing and go to lunch and go to the park, and then we'll be back by 3.
Well, they have to be back by 3. They have to start packing it by 2.
Actually a lot smoother the whole day, fewer kids that went, easier. I mean, at least if it's all a half hour, I think to just pack everything up and you're like, picked up and moving in the right direction. Yeah.
So that's money related. Do we need to have a motion or anything? Or are we just
that you're going to use the money for that?
I make a motion to use the donation of $250 for animal show to cover presentation and bus at the Woodman Institute for 6 hours or more. And that they can also visit Henry Law Park.
Do you have a second?
Yes.
A second, that's good. Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Sorry.
There you go.
You got it.
I'm like, are we missing?
You're good.
What's the date on that?
July 20th.
What's the date of the week?
Thursday.
And then you just want to bring us to Andy and Brittany's attention about the payment. Wanted to go on Field Trip Associates to get them.
I'll ask that because, which is actually a great segue into the next thing I was going to tell everybody, is that one of the things that we realized that we could do a little bit better between the rec committee versus the camp staff is have the flow of communication be a little different, because what's happening is we're bombarding them with information and things that, you know, I may say one thing and Kelly may say another. So we're, you know, not being on the basically the same page at times, and the same with the camp staff. Sometimes they weren't on the same page. But so an opportunity came out of it. We just decided the flow was gonna be for the committee, was gonna be for me, and Andy was gonna be the point person on behalf of Andy and Brittany. So anything that needs to be discussed with the camp staff, if you want to send it to me, I can go to them. And I make sure that once we can talk to them about things. Maybe okay, between the two parties.
Yeah,
so just make it easier for
everybody. Overwhelming,
yeah, it's overwhelming for all of us.
Yeah.
I mean, because poor Celia's there in the morning, and I go in there and I'm saying the same thing to them, and so.
I'm like, just
yeah. Yeah. They're like, okay, look, I got kids that I gotta watch. So I'm gotta respect their time too. So it's, anything, just bring, send it to me now.
I find them to be super organized and right on it. Like Andy is really working hard and working really hard about trying to be extremely safe, extremely organized, so.
Well,
from what I've seen, so.
Great segue. Into the next topic.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay, it's a great segue, it's camp staff. So the next topic I want to talk about is camp. So Andy like every 2 weeks will sit down, and he's going to be sitting down with his camp staff, and he's gonna talk to him about things, like constructive feedback. Almost like a performance review every 2 weeks. My question was gonna be put out to you guys, knowing that Andy does report to the select board, do we wanna do the same for them? Do we wanna sit down with him every 2 weeks and talk about any performance related issues or constructive feedback about
Andy?
Yeah. Okay. Now he reports to the select board, so how's that gonna work?
He reports to the select board directly, but we're the go-between between the select board.
Okay.
So we represent the select board. So
it's
the rec committee is a subcommittee of the select board.
Okay, so that would come from you, me, and Kelly, right? Actually, that was a great idea. Okay, so we can do that.
Question, I know the first week there was a counselor that showed up one or 2 days with just a regular shirt on. Is there something to say that they're supposed to wear their camp shirts every day or not?
They should. Right?
Isn't that why we gave them three?
Yeah.
They don't have three.
They have two, right?
Yeah. They so should the all have three now. I worked it out.
I was gonna say, I read something about three.
Brittany and one of the new staff took small sizes and Brittany gave her three to the three staff member that had mediums that were missing. So currently we only have three staff shirts that are an extra large. So all of the current counselors should have three shirts.
On Thursday there was two that weren't wearing staff shirts.
So I didn't know if that should be something that we talk about with Andy to disseminate it to his staff, that they need to be in camp shirts. I know Andy's been good about it.
I have a feeling Andy's probably
yeah,
that, but I've got it on my list and I'll talk to him about it in the morning.
Yep. Did it come up before I got here that parents wrote notes saying that they wanted their kid to walk home that day?
Mm-hmm.
So they got four notes this week saying that my kid's walking home. And he's nipping that in the bud. And so if you have the full support of the select board, because that was one of the select board issues.
Oh, yeah. He said you have to sign in and out.
Right.
And so his parents showed up and dropped off a letter saying, my kid's walking home today.
I talked to one of the parents about that too, and I told him she can.
Yeah.
Someone was just doing it.
But yeah,
they haven't yet. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, the staff's really good about it. Just like, okay, you know, we're going to sign out.
And I know I saw Andy sending a counselor to go chase down the parent the first week who didn't sign their child in. It's like,
yeah. All right, so in the spirit of performance reviews, I need you guys to give me your opinion on something. So I was told by somebody.
Is it personal?
It's
by anyone to go to
non-public. Yes, is that okay?
Yes.
Can
you motion to go to non-public or review personnel?
Yes.
Does that happen to me?
Roll call.
They have to, everybody has to back in.
Roll call.
Oh, we have to leave?
No.
Well, I have two subjects. So quickly.
Settle down.
I'm just kidding. So, three, and we're done.
Is she not going to be?
Yeah, he didn't do all stars or anything.
Once just
an FYI.
Okay, this is just a
little bit longer, but.
Okay. Denise Knowles came to the last select board meeting asking permission from the fire department and the select board to do movies in the park. By the fire department where the ice rink is, and she's going to use the money to fund the fireworks for the summer. For a family fun day, but she was, if we want to reach out to her and connect with her, the rec committee can work with her. She is an alternate on our committee. And she also wanted to know if any of the camp counselors would be interested in volunteering, if they need volunteer hours or anything, that live locally, volunteering with her for Family Fun Day. And help running the kid rides and with the kid games and stuff like that. So September 23rd, I believe. I'm getting a yes from the audience. It's September 23rd.
It's a Saturday.
It is a Saturday, but they wanted to know if any of our staff wanted to help and get volunteer hours, and then we could also put up a table with something about how someone went for Camp Raleigh and get people excited about it for next year, too. Okay. My second thing was the pizza. I know that the first week, we had...
Do we have to talk about pizza right now? We're going to go with Little Caesars. We've made a decision.
Well,
Caesars.
I want to tell you...
Using, but we will be using the gift cards for other things, like for the staff or the age groups.
Well,
age groups.
I've worked really, really hard, so I wanted to get this out there. Old Rail Pizza, which is in Somersworth, is 50 cents more per pizza, and it's a bigger pizza.
But that was the final gift.
Yeah, so it's $11 for a cheese pizza, so that's 50 cents more per pizza than Little Caesars, and it's a local business.
It is way better.
And
yeah, it is.
Okay. And
better.
It's bigger. So,
so good.
That would be, and they're,
please don't get
so I have a whole sheet. Well, that's my thing.
Food,
this is a what, super pizza,
right?
No.
That's a Little Caesar's pizza. Right?
No, this is Supa's pizza, which is 18 inches. So this is the side of Supa's. And this is 18 inches round. Supa's and the guy down here who is part of Borderline Fuel, or Borderline Stores.
Oh, used to be Mikey's Wicked Pie.
Yeah, they have both agreed to do 18-inch pizzas for us. And to make it profitable. So Supa's said they will give us any cheese or pepperoni, $8 each. And you can
put pizza chips.
Oh, well, that's cheap.
And so $8 for a pizza this size. And he says he cuts them into 8 slices, but I bought them a pizza cutter and they could cut them into 16 and they make double their money.
I know, that's the thing though. If they're going to be like that big, you're asking them to pay $1 for something that big. You know what I mean?
I guess just.
I love it. We're having art friends.
So this is not exact, but you're right. So it would be small. But.
Yeah. So I'm not gonna ask them to pay $1 for something that big.
Well, but I mean, they would be a regular sized pizza.
So they're making money on that.
So they're making double their money. On Little Caesars, you pay $5 for a 14-inch pizza. So that's 4 inches, or 2 inches in, on each side, and you make, say, you only have 8 pieces. This you could make.
We don't want
6
it. Okay. Here's what we're gonna do. Are you gonna? Can you be at the camp in the morning somewhere this week?
Yes.
Preferably maybe Tuesday.
Yes, that'd be good.
Camp.
Well,
can't stay long, anyways. But can you be there Tuesday morning?
Yes.
Let's you and me and Andy. You and me and Andy. Let's talk about the whole pizza thing.
And then the other thing is about making a profit is that last year we had to buy all, or in the previous years they had to buy all the waters, and we got 375 bottles of water through 2 gift cards that were donated. So we're making $375 on bottles of water.
Maybe.
They turn
over to the
town.
They're not selling
so far.
It. They're not selling the snacks. That's one of the problems.
The snacks and the water are not moving, right?
They're not being offered. I keep asking my children, what did you buy today? And they're like,
Okay.
I was like,
five
Reese
pops a day.
Yeah, my son gets.
Oh, when I was there selling from. No, you saw me.
Yeah,
there.
And it
I
never goes,
were,
no, no,
online.
Only pack 20 cents. We can only buy 2. I was like,
yeah, so I'm sending them with a dollar and they're coming home with like 90 cents. Or they're losing it or they didn't get anything. Or,
so,
I'm like,
I'm going to have Brittany put that in the newsletter.
So
and just remind the parents there it is available.
But I don't think it's a parent thing, I think it's a counselor.
I don't think the counselors are giving them times to go buy the snacks. It's not open.
So
scheduled.
Oh,
So maybe we need, when it's snack time, have something there.
Where are the snacks located, just in the?
I know.
Is that, they're saying they're sending money, but their kids don't have an opportunity to buy.
I see, let them buy.
Because the kids are not gonna go into the medical unit to get snacks.
Right.
Some of the snacks need to be here, we have snacks, you know what I mean?
I see, I thought you were saying that it just wasn't moving, I got it.
I wonder if they, I wonder if they, if the eighth grade, if the eighth grade could man the snack table, like if they set the table and just rotate the, to give them a little.
I know there are some older kids that are looking.
The staff doesn't want them in there, yeah.
That's true, but if maybe the staff brought them out.
Yeah, like set a little table and.
Yeah, because there are some kids there who don't necessarily really wanna be there because they're going in eighth grade and their friends aren't there and they're like twiddling their thumbs a little bit and some of it, you know, gave them some jobs to do.
Oh, what about, are they being offered at lunchtime, you know, or?
I only getting freeze pops.
I would have to go back.
My daughter does not even realize that there's crackers. The only reason why my kids knew is because the bulletin board, like Kathy, Kathy and Joe, you have it.
Could be a.
But let me.
Week three, that could be a.
We'll talk to them in the morning, so we'll snack on.
So.
Snack and more.
Were you gonna review the budget or anything?
No, actually, the only thing I was gonna do was just remember that September is we have a target date for, to get the budget together. We can't realistically do it right now, so we don't really have a formal finances, which Lester said within the next week or two, he's gonna go see Caroline and sit together with her and make sure we are, we have an actual versus budget and we are caught up on the numbers so we can actually see how we're doing real time, so, perfect. That's the only thing I was gonna say.
Just the issue with taking pictures at camp. So our release says that it's only for camp use. So there's, we had a resident take pictures and asked them not to. Pictures stayed up, videos stayed up.
We got the email on it too, from a parent
yes.
too.
Yes, so we got the email from the parent as well. So our response is that we can't stop people from taking it. They're on public property. People can go on the side of the road and take pictures if they like. No, if you're not a parent, you're in that area, it is off limits. So there's no difference between a resident taking pictures and anybody else taking pictures.
So as far as camp staff
is concerned. So when camp staff is concerned, make sure that they are well aware of their surroundings, and if they do see somebody, please get a license plate so we can address it with the police, because we do have parents that are single parents, and you know, one parent may have custody of the child for the summer, and if the parent sees them at summer camp, then they want this child back, because if you're gonna put my kid in summer camp, then I want the child back. So.
My question would be from the rec committee perspective is, can we use kids' pictures as forms of marketing? To say, hey, summer camp was awesome, check this out. I mean, we can do that on our own Facebook pages and our own published.
Our publishing says for rec use.
Okay, but we're the residents.
So it's not for the public page, it's not. It's a closed page for the parents. If you've noticed, our Raleigh camp rec program, whatever, has no children's pictures on it.
But we need.
But we don't need real-time photos of children. I do not want my child in a real-time photo when I'm not with them. When I post Zoe's picture of her getting her All-Star picture, I'm home by then. She is not at the field still. So. I feel extremely uncomfortable with people having, because when you take a photo and put it on social media, they can tell where you are, whether you put your notifier on or not. They can track your movements. So, nothing we can do, but to the staff to please be aware.
Okay.
Well, so, and they are not allowed on school grounds if they are not part of our committee or parents.
So, we need pictures for the REF grant.
Yes.
So.
And that's for rec use only after the fact. Are you gonna post them that day?
Probably not.
While you're taking the photo with a parent not with them and making it real time?
No, no. I'll take pictures that are, so we need pictures of that day and probably pictures of the Wentworth House, just so these groups can have them too.
Yeah, I think it's good for, you know, next year, we want it for publications of our own.
Absolutely.
They come from the town, or.
So.
Is there one kid?
That's what the waiver says.
That we can't take pictures of at all?
There's one.
Is there one?
And without my book, I don't recall who that is.
Is there any way, I know that the four of you are on the closed group to see what's going on, but is there any way for the rest of us committee members who don't have children there to get on that group, or is that not okay?
I think how it said is for.
Because we technically are helping.
Brittany's said that she just put up the private picture page.
She hasn't posted. So she posted a day, so.
Yeah, there's numbers there.
But I mean, I think Kathy and I might wanna see like pictures of the Kachikos coming in, or the special events that have been planned, like the thing at the Woodman Institute. It'd be nice to get pictures of that.
Jimmy, if you're part of the rec committee, I mean, I'll just talk to Brittany, I don't think that's a big deal.
Yeah, you're appointed by the select board.
Yeah.
Yeah, you should be able to just ask.
Talk to Brittany.
Yeah, and that's a closed group, so. That's why she wanted all the parents' names, so she can flag them herself.
Okay.
So when do you want me to bump the police department to, just pick a date, like in August maybe?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep, sounds good. Thanks, Jim.
No.
Yep.
Motion to adjourn. Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
There you go.
Thank you, guys.
I'm like, y'all are back.
If I email you, do we have the numbers on the t-shirts? Oh, I was gonna talk about t-shirts, some other, we need to order more. I guess I'll send out an email instead.
I thought I said, yeah, we should probably show it, right?
Yeah, but let me.
We need to open it up for sure.
No. I will send an email, but nobody responded to my email about whether or not we should order more t-shirts.
We're going to the rest, so.